Hello and welcome to the Danesh Show. I'm Noah Danesh. Today with a very special guest, Shaun Toub. Thank you so much for joining me, Mr. Toub.
Thank you for having me.
Shaun has been an actor on several different movies and television for over 30 years now.
Yes.
So, Shaun, what got you into acting?
You know, I wanted to be an actor since I was 5 years old. So it's just the bug that I have. I always believe that, you know, acting is something that you have, it's in your blood. You can't teach it. You can get better as you work and as you practice. But so when I was 5 years old in Manchester, I was raised in Manchester. So they used to ask me, what do you want to do? As, you know, they ask kids. Mm-hmm. I always used to say, you know, I want to be an actor, and they used to shush me, and I would say you want to be a doctor or an engineer or attorney or something. So, and then, you know, when I went to Switzerland for high school, I wrote a long letter to my father and saying I want to go to U.S. and become an actor, and he just basically said, I will disown you. That was it. That was the answer of a 10-page letter. So and then I came to New Hampshire for high school, and then Boston, and then transferred to USC. And make a long story short, I was doing real estate brokerage, and I met an agent, and I used to tell him I always wanted to be an actor. So his name was David Wilder, and he had an agency. I was big at the time, and so one day we were celebrating a lease because I was in leasing. I did his office lease in a building, and I was basically, you know, we were just messing around, and he had me, you know, I said, I really always wanted to be an actor. He goes, you know, you have a good look. So there was a scene of a kid who just lost his father. He goes, read this. And meanwhile, you know, I would see 30 kids out there in the waiting room always, every time I would go see him. So I was like, okay, I'll take that on. And I jumped on it, and 5 minutes later I came in and did my thing, and he looked at me, he goes, you've been yanking my chain? And I go, no, why? He goes, no training? I go, no. So he goes, you know, take some pictures. And I go, I'm not gonna spend $2,000 on pictures. So he goes, you know what, somebody owes me a favor, I'll pull a favor, there's something there. 3 weeks later, he called me. He goes, you know, I want you to go on an audition. And I went, and I said, what is it? And he wouldn't tell me because I guess he didn't want me to get scared, but it was for Rambo 4. Mm-hmm. And I went for the audition, and I went all the way to the end, callbacks, and Stallone didn't like me because I was too tall. And funny enough, I'm an Academy member now, so I vote. So now they invite me to, you know, to events because they want my vote. And I had a luncheon with Stallone last year for Creed, and I went up to him. I go, "You were my first rejection," and he goes, "What are you talking about?" So I told him the story, and he was like, "Oh my God!" I go, "Yep, that's how I got into it."
Yeah. Well, a big part of being an actor is being rejected a lot of times. How do you deal with that? Being rejected from a TV show or a movie?
Thick skin. You know, this is not easy, and I always tell people, you know. If you want to be an actor and you want to do this because you want to be famous or rich, don't do this, because you can get rich so many other ways, and you don't want to be famous. Actually, I think Will Smith said it once on an interview, and he said, you know, a reporter asked, and he said, no, you want to be rich, you don't want to be famous, because you lose a lot of privacy and stuff. But you know, that be an actor because you love the process. Mm-hmm. And it's sometimes personal. You know, you're too tall, you're too short, you're too ugly, you're too handsome, you are, you know, not white enough, not dark enough. And so there's always something. But you just have to believe. You really have to believe that this is what you want to do.
Mm-hmm. And so there are all the difficulties, but what are some of your favorite parts of being an actor?
I love being an actor. You know, I've being in the business for so many years, you know, the natural progression is to become a director sometimes, because I have a very detailed eye, and it's just naturally I see. My wife always says, and you know, Lorena always says, you know, I see everything, and I see everything in detail. And so many people have offered for me to direct, and I just love the process of acting, and mm-hmm. I'm still not there. I'm still enjoying being an actor. Mm-hmm. And it's a bug. It's, as I said, I wanted to do this since I was 5 years old. I'm fascinated by it. Mm-hmm. Just to create something from a page and, you know, create a character that people can watch.
Yeah. How do you go about that? How do you go about when you see they give you the script with the character? How do you go about transferring that into acting?
It takes a while sometimes, you know, but with me, every actor is different. But with me, if I read a script and I read a character and he doesn't talk to me, then I know that I'm not connecting, mm-hmm. and I usually don't take the job. But when I, for example, you know, Crash, of course, Crash, the script was incredible. I mean, incredible. Everybody who read it, they were like, oh my God, because every actor in town wanted to be on that project. Mm-hmm. And I was very blessed to have the opportunity to be in that. But when I read it, I see it. I saw the character. I knew the unkempt mustache. I knew how he walked. He had the limp. You know, the way he stood. You know, it's very different than who I am, mm-hmm. the character itself. But I could see him.
So let's actually watch a clip from Crash. We can see that character. So let's look at the clip.
So, give me my money.
What? What money?
Pay for my store. Give me my money.
Honey, stay inside. Elizabeth!
Give me my money.
Aplácate, espera.
Give me the truck.
That's not my truck, bro. Elizabeth! Hey, you okay? You know what? Hey, I got $50. Here, $50. You took everything. Look.
Mommy, coming, I'm coming.
He doesn't have it.
Has not what?
I have it. He doesn't have it for paper clothes.
Lara, stand in the street.
So when you're doing this character, how do you do it? How many times did you have to, you know, work hard to make a scene like that?
Actually, that was a very special film. That film is very dear to my heart. I mean, not only because it won the Oscar, but it was a very difficult process because, you know, when I met with them for the audition, Paul Haggis, who was the director and writer of the film, they liked me a lot, and they kept on telling the agency, you know, we love Shaun, but he's just too young for the role. And I kept on suggesting, I said, you know, I know that I'm too young, but, you know, I have to do some aging. And so the process was very difficult to get that job because everybody, you know, they had actors coming in from all over the place, mm-hmm. For that role. And we went through a very difficult process to get that job and to prove to them that I can basically handle that. So it just depends on the process. Sometimes it's just, you know, sometimes it's easier, sometimes it's straight offer and you get into it. Sometimes you gotta work really hard for it.
For that specific movie, Crash, how did you achieve the aged look to be able to get that role eventually?
You know, the first time I saw them, they were very kind and they were very nice. And the casting director, actually, I just saw her yesterday again for another project. I did actually Iron Man with the same casting director. So they came, they brought me in, and we did this, and then I, you know, then they told the agency, they said, we like him a lot, but he's too young. And then a couple of weeks later, they called me back and they said, listen, there's some actors coming in. Can you please come in again? And, you know, let's see if we can make this work. So I came in with a couple other actors, and then again, they called back to say, we love him. He's the first year, but he's just too young for the role. So a week later or so, they called and they said, listen, we know who we want for the Michael Peña character. And so they said, you know, we would love to have a kind of a chemistry test and see if we can make it work. So I went in and we did the thing. And then the night before, actually, I was filming in downtown and I had a night shoot. Mm. And I had to be at this meeting at 9 o'clock in the morning. So I figured, I said, you know what? I'm just gonna go and do the shoot and stay up all night. So naturally you're tired, you know, you look older when mm-hmm. you are, you know, when you're up all night. So I didn't shave and everything. The character was a street bum. But I went in the morning and I went, you know, we did the chemistry test and I did the thing. And then so the agency, you know, I asked them, so what happened? They said, yeah, we called them. So I said, okay, what happened though? They said, did I look older? And they said, no, Shaun looked tired. So I was like, oops, I guess that didn't work.
That didn't work.
Yeah. So they called 10 days later. I said, okay, that's mm-hmm, done. That's, I'm not going to, yeah. Yeah, it's gone. So 10 days later, the producer called actually my house and says, Shaun, you know, can you come in again? I go, I'm sorry, but I've given you all I got. Mm-hmm. I can't be any better than this. Mm-hmm. I don't have it. So if it's not me, then it's, they said, no, listen, you know, I understand your concerns and this and that. Why don't you just come in for a makeup test, and we do a test with makeup, with the wardrobe and everything. I said, great, okay, that I will do. So I went in and I told the guy, to the makeup person, what exactly I wanted. You know, I as I said, I saw this character, so mm-hmm. I said, I want an unkept mustache. And she was like, seriously? I go, yeah. I said, you know, get wrinkles, and I want wrinkles around the neck. Mm-hmm. And I told wardrobe, I want, you know, thicker sweater than and a vest on it and a jacket on it. And so it, like, old, you know, older clothes, yeah, that somebody would wear like that, that with that character. And we were supposed to be there in front of the camera for an hour to do a screen test. I went in, I think it took like 30 seconds. I walked in and everybody went like, oh my God, that's him. So they said, give us some looks, and I did it and I said, okay, thank you very much, you're done. So that's the process. Mm-hmm. Sometimes wow. It's crazy.
And how was it like working on a movie that went on to win a Best Picture Oscar?
As I said, this is it's something that you will never forget, because mm-hmm. at that moment when they call, you know, Crash, you know, the Best Picture, it's something that you dream about, mm-hmm. and you always chase that. And but Crash is really, honestly, it's a special film. Mm-hmm. It really resonated with so many people. I went into theaters at times and would sit in the back of the theater just to see people's reaction, and it was just incredible. And I still, you know, when I hear the music from Crash, it just does something to me. Mm-hmm. So Crash, but I've been blessed. I've had some, you know, projects that have been incredible, like The Kite Runner, mm-hmm. you know, based on a best-selling book. And, you know, there have been so many of them that have been so dear to my heart. Yeah. Iron Man was another one.
Yeah. Well, actually, we'll take a look at a clip for that one, too.
Go for it.
So let's look.
Now!
Tell me.
Function 11. Tell me when you see a progress bar. It should be up right now. Talk to me. Okay, tell me when you see it.
I have it.
Press Control I.
I.
Got enter. It. Okay. I and enter. Come over here and button me up.
Hey. I'm gonna go buy you some time.
Stick to the plan!
So what was it like working on Iron Man?
Iron Man was incredible. But I mean, be honest, nobody thought that this is going to become what it is today, you know? Mm-hmm. Iron Man was the beginning of the franchise. So it's just basically, you know, I'm in first 40 minutes of the film. Mm-hmm. And, you know, everybody was talking about if it doesn't work the first, you know, hour of the film, we're in trouble. Mm-hmm. And that's probably one of the reasons that that they killed the character, because they wanted to bring the audience in. Mm-hmm. You know, they want some emotion. Yeah. Because Jensen actually is a very popular character in the comic book world. So mm-hmm. Some of the fans were not happy about that. Actually, John Favreau, the director, I received an award and he sent the tape in. And one it was very sweet of him, actually, and he said that if it wasn't, you know, if I knew that Iron Man is going to become this big, I would have never killed Shaun. But working on Iron Man was another, mm-hmm. because honestly, a lot of it we improvised.
Really?
Believe it or not, on a big project like this,
really?
You know, Robert is very good at that. Mm-hmm. You know, he's very quick on his mm-hmm. feet. And you know, another process, you know, to show you how it happens for me, it's like 3 days before, you know, they had me in a garb, in a Afghani garb and everything, and I kept on saying that I'm not comfortable with this. I just don't see Jensen looking like this. And I was talking to Robert, and I was saying, you know, Robert, I'm not comfortable with what I'm wearing. And this was like 3 days before the shoot. So we were sitting in the conference room with the writers and everything. We're talking about the scenes, and somebody said something about a suit. And I went, wait a minute. And they said, what happened? I go, Jensen is wearing a suit. It just clicked all of a sudden. Mm-hmm. And then I turned to Robert. I said, Robert, Jensen is wearing a three-piece suit. And he was very, very sweet. He goes, hey, man, I love you. And I whatever you say, I'll back you up. Mm-hmm. Go for it, you know, just. So I tell John, you know, I Jensen is in a three-piece suit. I'm telling you. And he was very sweet. And he goes, show me. So I went to wardrobe, and wardrobe went and bought 15 suits, three-piece suits to pick. Mm-hmm. And then I said, okay, you know, I'll show you. And then I got the glasses, and you know, the glasses that you see. I mean, little things happened, you know. I don't know if you noticed, but, you know, Jensen has a little twitch when he's doing, you know, he has a little twitch, but that just mm-hmm. that just comes at the character, you know? Yeah. Like Crash, you know, you know, he had a little limp. Mm-hmm. And then, so I put on the suit, I put the glasses on, and I walked in, and they were like, okay, that's Jensen. Mm-hmm. You know, so that's how it became Jensen. So, Iron Man was amazing, mm-hmm. and it's incredible what has happened to
Marvel.
Exactly.
Yeah, the Iron Man was the first of the series, which went on to actually to the Avengers, the whole Marvel Cinematic Universe. So that was pretty
much
the start of it.
Yeah.
And what was it like working with so many great people on Iron Man? You know, you had Jon Favreau, you had Robert Downey Jr.
I mean, Robert and I, the editor always was saying that it seems like we have done 15 movies together. The chemistry was just there, you know. Mm-hmm. We just understood, and it was, you know, a lot of great people on the show, and from the suit makers and, you know, the stunt people, everybody was like incredible.
Well, another great movie you worked on was Papa, which you filmed in Cuba. Can you talk about that movie?
Papa was you know, it's the first American movie made in Cuba in the past 60 years. So Papa is the life story of Hemingway. Mm-hmm. And it's that portion of his life story that nobody has ever told. And it is the portion that he lived in Cuba and what happened to him in Cuba. And I play Evan Shipman, who's an American poet, and his best friend. And Papa is a beautiful film. Actually, the producer of Crash, Bob Yari, directed Papa, mm-hmm. and produced it. And it's a beautiful film. You guys will enjoy it. Actually, you guys should see it because Hemingway is loved, and it's a portion of his life story that is really interesting. Yeah. And you know, being in Cuba, and this is we shot it like 3 years ago, before that we opened up Cuba, mm-hmm. and nobody was going there at the time, mm-hmm. per se. But we had the permission to go, and it's really amazing because you are in a time capsule. Mm-hmm. You know, you land in Cuba and you go back 50 years. All of a sudden, cars are 50 years, 60 years old, and from back in the day, all those just American cars, yeah. and it's incredible. I hope to God that things get better for them, though.
Yeah.
Because it's tough. It's tough to be in Cuba.
What were some of the difficulties in filming this movie in Cuba?
You know, it's you get used to American projects, and you get used to your trailers and this and that. And Cuba was nothing like that. And that's why it's incredible. We were the only production, even Cuban, that was allowed to shoot in the Finca. The Finca is the Hemingway's house, which is a museum. Like something like crazy numbers, like 80,000 people a year go through that house. Of course, you're not allowed to go inside. Mm-hmm. We actually got to shoot inside that whole film. Wow. Yeah, and they loved the project so much that the Cuban government allowed us to shoot, and nobody had ever been allowed to, even Cubans.
Wow. So Papa, that seems like a really great movie.
Yeah, it's a great film. Mm-hmm. It's a great film.
What do you see? Do you see yourself acting some more? Do you see branching off to directing or anything? Or are you going to stick with acting in the future?
You know, as I said, it's something that I've always been asked to do, and everybody thinks because of my detailed eye. But right now, I'm just mm-hmm. enjoying. I'm really enjoying mm-hmm. the acting process. Yeah. I have the desire to do it, and there's a couple mm-hmm. of projects that I've been, a couple of scripts that I've been working on, mm-hmm. but I've had no time to really commit.
Yeah.
And directing is a whole different ball game. I mean, mm-hmm. you're going from A to Z. You know, we come in as actors and we do our thing and we leave. Mm-hmm. I mean, directors have to do it pre-production, set everything up way before everybody else gets in
there. The whole process.
And then they are stuck with it after we leave, mm-hmm. the editing, and then finishing it up, the film, the music, that. It's a lot of work. Yeah. It's no joke.
No joke. And then finally, the question I like to ask all my guests is, what is the best advice you've ever received in your life?
I guess never give up. You know, if you really believe, and if you really want it bad enough, then you gotta go for it, mm-hmm. and don't be scared. Failure is part of life. Somebody said, if you fail, that's not a failure. That's just a learning process mm-hmm. for you to go forward. You know, so people really. Put too much into, everybody fails. But the point is to get up and learn from it and go forward. Yeah. As I said, if you want it bad enough, though.
Mm-hmm. Well, Shaun, thank you so much for joining me.
Pleasure.
Today.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Thank you all for watching, and we will see you next time.